Gardening is all about passion, a passion for growing. Roses create so much passion in some people that it goes far beyond the garden.
I'm a fashion designer and I put roses on everything. That's what I do. A rose is a rose. Like, a rose never goes out of style.
It's very beautiful. It's very mathematical. Putting in the effort to learn to fold a paper rose and then giving that over to the other person makes it more special than anything.
A lot of people want something that sets them apart, makes them unique.
The rose really, I think, spoke to all of our customers.
If somebody were to wear it, it definitely would stand out in a crowd.
I mean, who doesn't love roses?
This rose parade will be the 124th rose parade. I love roses. I can't tell you a rose I don't really like.
Being fortunate to be selected as the builder for Scott's Miracle-Gro on their first float ever in the rose parade. We use probably about 24 different varieties of roses. They're our number one flower.
The variety of roses is endless. There's thousands of types of roses.
So here we have the Peace Rose. Well, this rose has a long history of being smuggled and moved around during World War II. One of the best cut flowers that you can take to your sweetie. Double delight. Called double, of course, because of the two colors.
Yes.
And delight, because it's delightful.
How can you not be delighted when you see it?
Barbara Bush. It's kind of cool how each of the first ladies gets a rose. Rosalind Carter. This is a great color, the flower. Pat Nixon.
She's definitely a special one here.
I would say so. In the Pat Nixon Rose Garden, Flight 93911.
We thought it was a good place to put a remembrance rose. It's got that really nice, rich red color.
Absolutely a beautiful rose.
They're so beautiful. They come back every single year. They're extremely tough.
One of those flowers that inspire that passion. No aspect of gardening elicits more passion than roses. What's your favorite rose?